This is the 1FM Breakfast Show with TNG.
1FM 97.1 is an amazing song. Score DM Chick by Harmonize and Sakodi. Karibu sana kwenye show for all y'all tuning into the show from across the Republic. Can you remember, we are broadcasting from the capital city, Nairobi, 97.1 Mombasani. Na watu wa coast, tupo gangari kabisa, 107.3 Rift Valley, Nakuru and beyond. We are live on 106.5. It's 254 Tuesday at any time with me, DNG. Remember, you can catch this amazing interview on our YouTube channel, 254 TV, and of course, Instagram, Facebook, DNG Kenya. But I know you. Today, my guest, Mheshimiwa Ndani Nyumba.
Niko sawa kabisa.
Mtu wa nguvu kabisa, Honorable Babu Wino, MP for Embakasi East. Welcome to the 1FM Breakfast Hot Seat.
Asante.
Tunasema ni mambo ya vijana, youth power muda.
Youth TV.
TV! Ni noma sana mzee. Today it's 254 Tuesday, so we just want to find out and just assess where we are at as a country, you know, the mistakes we've made, this new budget, and find out, are we heading in the right direction? First, let's have your opinion. I know you read the budget, you are there in Bunge. What are your thoughts?
I think the budget has so much to be talked about, because there are so many issues that are very relevant in the budget.
Mm-hmm.
As a person who passed it, I might have had a contrary opinion, but being only one member of parliament or two guys, it didn't make sense, because either way, there were a majority who wanted the budget to be passed so that Kenya can move on. But all in all, the budget personally is not pleasing at all. Matters that we are going to discuss shortly.
Yeah, is there anything in particular you do not like about this budget?
There are several things I don't like about the budget. The punitive tax,
yes,
that has been imposed.
Mm-hmm.
This tax on the money transfers that has been put. There's the budget itself, the around 3 trillion, compared to other countries like Tanzania, Uganda, and Rwanda, which have relatively lower taxes. Lower budgets.
Mm-hmm.
Look at Rwanda, for example, which is very well developed, and the budget that they are using on annually is very little.
I think that Kenya has a great direction in mind in terms of this infrastructural development projects. But the problem is we tax the common mwananchi so hard, but yet this money goes into the pockets of a very few people. You know, you find me? Like now we're taxing the country, then guys are buying jets. Miraculously, my guy. Abracadabra, funga macho, funga fubua, kuna ma helicopter mzai. So really, what are we saying?
I think this issue of budget, first of all, Kenya is having a budget of 3 trillion.
Mm-hmm.
When KRA was asked, they said that they can only give out 1.5 trillion.
In terms of collections.
Mm. So how will we raise the rest of the 1.5 trillion? Which means we are living in debt. It is something that we will never achieve. And you can't spend what you don't have.
I was taught
in first year, my
savings,
my class law.
There's
Nemo that quote, the third rule, that says you can never spend what you don't have.
Exactly.
And look at the 1.5 trillion that KRA can offer. Out of that, around 800 billion is going towards that.
Yeah.
Now, we negotiated with the government negotiated with IMF, which accepted that they can loan us, but on one condition, that around 60,000 civil servants
have to lose jobs. Yeah. Babu, do you know how many people are looking at you like, wow, Babu Owino alitoboa, Jagwa alitoboa. Yani, these are guys tumegrow now, tumetafuta now, tumetumama proposals now. This is reminding you to kwa meeting, tunaitisha kazi.
Nakumbuka bro,
unakumbuka kufanya campaigns,
hustle sana ma campaigns ma 2013 tukizunguka around.
We,
lakini najua bro, God pia ana play a big role.
Yes.
Kwa sababu when somebody is not dead, at least bado kuna your ambition, your God has a plan for you.
You have time.
Bado kuna time, you can make it at any time.
And how has your life changed, Babu, as a result of that position?
Mimi bro, mimi am a normal person.
Mm-hmm.
Mimi na associate na everybody. Si bagui mtu yote, kwa sababu I came from the bottom.
Okay.
I know how these people feel. When they tell me that I wanna do ya lunch, ama wanna do ya school fee, mimi na feel, mimi najua.
How do you help everybody?
I can only help to certain extent, bro. Mimi, ile kidogo enye niko nayo. The good thing with me, mimi niko na very kind heart. Mimi hata ukinidanganya tu kuna shida fulani. Ile kama niko nayo hiyo wakati,
unatoboka.
Na kama sina, hata naweza uza kiatu yangu nitembee barefoot.
Is it a bad mentality that we have as Kenyans that we always look to our leaders like MPs for money?
It's not a bad mentality, bro. It's because we don't have.
Bunge huko tunataka at least mweke legislation fulani ya wasanii bwana.
Bana wasanii tumesahau bro. Wasanii tumesahau. Sana nafaa tu improve wasanii wetu. Tuweke hata ka budget fulani wasanii wakiwa na mambo mashida kidogo wakuje wachukue loan kwa hiyo budget. Wafanye nao muziki yao na wapewe time ya kulipa.
Do you know I was in South Africa last year around October and some of the provinces like KwaZulu, Natal, Gauteng, the Eastern Cape, Western Cape, they have funds where you can actually if you film in that province you can get rebates, tax rebates, you can get loans from funds that have been set up by government for artisans and filmmakers. Sisi tuko nyuma manze.
Manze, we don't even think of artists. You know, I've met several artists of late. And the way wananiambia bwana, ni kama Kenya wamewasahau maartist. Na maartist, ni wana to make, tuna enjoy. Manze, umefanya kazi from Monday to Friday. And then saato ukienda hata
kwa club mahali
una dance huyo ati sana sana lakini akikuja kwako for help
hakuna kitu
mzee utaki ku help.
Sisi tunasemanga ni msanii kwa mathri na mafans kwa bima but I think government needs to recognize that this is an industry and it has the potential to even generate the revenue that government is looking for in taxes.
Yeah, it can do.
Yes,
because, once we big business our wasanii utapata kama wanapata so many international events
yeah
watakuwa kireizi hizi mado. Na mwenye watakuwa kireza hata jina The Nation. Wakijua huu msanii anatoka place kama isikia wasanii kama Ama and West African artist. Penye jina zao ziko everywhere.
Like now with
wana hapa hata Tanzania hapa.
Wanapepea kabisa.
Wapo wakikuja hapa wanakuwa celebrated more than our local artists.
Do you know international brand Nike teamed up with Nigerian artists like kina Wizkid for an endorsement deal for the Nigerian World Cup jersey and it's out of stock. Imeuza zote. Yani
because of the love.
The love. First Africa team ile ya maana iko pale ni gani? Si ni Nigeria.
Ndio watu wanajua.
Ndio tunatambua, unaona? Super Eagles. Man, and from there, you know, we just want to, you know, go back to political agenda. Talk about the handshake. Babu, we saw a photograph. You and His Excellency. Wachana ile ya baba na unye. Pia yako ilikuwa pale. What is the impact of the handshake in total?
I think bro when I shook Uhuru's hands. Those were two presidents.
I like that.
The current.
Are you seeing now the vice president? This is the Minister of Youth and Entertainment, Top Shot at DNG.
Team TV.
Team TV.
Now, bro.
Yes.
The handshake, I think, it will bring more happiness to Kenyans. Because we've fought, and the Bible says that there's a time for everything: a time to fight and a time to make peace, a time to sow and a time to reap what you've sown. And bro. What I know very well is that this handshake is meant to bring hope. Why? Because we have Raila Amolo Odinga, who's been into politics for so many years, over 30 years.
An icon.
An icon. Baba. We've seen a person who's shelved his ambitions for the sake of the Kenyan interest. He did that in 2002 when he supported Kibaki.
Yeah.
He ought to have gone for the presidency. We saw that in 2007 when he decided that no more Kenyan should die and chose to take the premiership position. We saw that in 2013 and recently in 2018 when there was the handshake, the 2017 elections. And bro, and we have President Uhuru Kenyatta, who's also risen to higher echelons of power until the presidency and is the number one now, the president of the Republic of Kenya. These two people cannot shake hands just for the sake of shaking hands. These two people mean well for the interest of the Kenyan citizen. One.